gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another episode of Leigh-Ality TV, coming at you live from StrongIslands.com. This is everybody's favorite white boy, Mr. Leigh West. Right alongside Bad Ass Becca, we're coming to bring you some more entertaining entertainment. What kind of news is that? I don't know. What up, Becca? Say what up to the people.
Hi, people.
Yeah, thank you all for tuning in. I very much appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed last week's episode. If you missed it, you can catch it on StrongIslands.com and MrLeighWest.com. And we're here. We're gonna do it again. Keep trying. We got a couple more things for you this week. We got two guests. We got a little music in the background. If you can't hear it, sounds like a little something. Shout out my brother DJ G Wiz in the building.
What's up,
my brother? Shout out to DJ Itchy for putting that little track together for us. My little intro. I hope you all enjoyed it. I feel like it's really like.
I love that song.
I just thought you guys are, you know, you got the flyer up. You can't see me, but I'm over here. I'm doing all of this. You know, I'm just doing what I do best. We got Keith Fitz in the building with us this evening. Yay, Keith Fitz. Yeah. All right. And that's it, man. Yeah, there it is. That's the one. That's the one. All right, great. Becca. So we had a wonderful meeting, me and Becca, this week. We sat around with some great topics, talk with all y'all guys. And the topic that's been churning in my head mostly is, the one at the bar. Like, so, ladies, gentlemen, and we're in the chat room this week. I effed up on that a little bit last week. We'll be in here. And so I want your feedback on this one. When you buy a lady a drink at the bar, mm-hmm. What is your expectations, and also what is she required for said drink?
Well, it's your standpoint and my standpoint. So if you're the guy and you're buying a drink,
go closer.
What do you expect in return?
Right.
Do you expect anything, or is it just a form of communication?
I'm a different breed of dude. You know what I mean? I got bitches buying me drinks. You know what I'm saying?
I'm up in there. He's got it like that.
What up, ladies? Pizza rock on the rocks. Rah! You know. But Wizzy on point. But alright, check it, Becca. So, hypothetical situations.
Hypothetically speaking.
Right? You at the other end of the bar, you don't know me, you just see me, I'm some dude over here chilling. Da 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 da. Right? And then you down the other end of the bar, I'm like, yo, bartender, get Badass Becca over there. I didn't know your name yet. Go get her a little something to drink, you know.
Stalker.
Yeah. I'm all up and I'm liking every Instagram she got, you know. And so I'm like, hey, you know, let me buy her a drink. Now, you get said drink. You're not really, your eyes ain't working right, whatever. You're not really feeling the physical outstanding.
I don't have beer goggles yet, you mean.
Right. Whatever. Right, I'm not a steroid-eating gorilla is what she means.
Oh, I can't help it. They're hot.
So, anyway. So, and what is your reaction to me purchasing this drink for you?
Well, it depends. It depends on the approach. It depends if you come over and talk to me with some cornball lines or not.
No, I sent a drink to you. Like, I'm at the
then
other
I'll
end of the bar.
Give me a cheers and drink it.
From all the way down there. You're just going to do like...
I don't do that shit. I'd rather buy my own drink.
You're one of those.
I'd rather buy my girlfriend's drink.
Stop.
If you come over with some stupid lines and trying to buy drinks, then you're going to end up spending a lot of money and going home with your dick in your hand.
Personally, I feel if I went as far as into my pocket to come out to buy you this drink over the goodness of my heart, my personal opinion is you walk your ass 8 bar stools down... Cheers me in person and say thank you. Whether you're feeling the dude or not.
It depends.
How does it depend?
It depends on the appearance.
The
approach.
So only if you're taking cock out is you going to come over.
No. If it's
I'm not going to waste 8 steps on being polite. You know.
I'm not going to waste the breath on saying hello. If a guy is buying a girl a drink as a conversation starter to get to know a girl and has the balls to go up to her and say, hey, how are you doing? My name is so-and-so, and have a normal conversation, fine. I'm all for it. But if a guy buys a girl a drink and acts like he's a stage five clinger and now he owns you for
yeah,
the night
yeah, it is them
and
dudes
you owe
too.
Him
yeah, yeah,
something,
yeah, 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 yeah.
I will tear you a new asshole.
Yeah, they're them dudes out there that think, oh, I bought you a drink. I own you now.
You don't own nothing. You nah, own that yeah, drink. Nah, that's nah, about
nah.
it.
And it's going to be pee soon. Yeah, no, it's I use it specifically as a conversation starter, you
well,
know.
That's different.
Normally, I'll get you something that I drink. And then you're like, oh, my God, this is so good. And I'm like, I have some more stuff you can put in your mouth. That is so good.
I'm sure
or
you
what,
do.
Or whatever. I don't really
see,
know.
Now right there, you get a drink in your face.
Right. Yeah, it's cool. You know, whatever.
He's
I'm
used
like,
to that.
I do my nugget tongue and just, Nugget's my dog. And I just lick my whole face. Like, it doesn't matter.
Oh, what about what you find sexy as far as men's and women's underwear? You could do the women's,
oh, yeah, yeah.
and I'll do the men's.
All right. You know, I like no underwear.
Well, that always works.
You know, or like a little something. You know, it depends. It depends on what she's doing, you know.
Do you like
don't be a hooch.
Booty shorts.
I like booty shorts. I like booty shorts.
G-strings.
I like
where it's
G-strings.
Just a string or it's
whatever.
A little bit of the lace that frames
I like
the butt.
I like the lace. I guess I'm not very partial to underwear. Fuck, I'm going to cut them shits off anyway. Literally, taking my knife out and cutting them.
He's like Crocodile Dundee.
You know, and then by the time you get to that point, it's... Bite the pillow. Bite the pillow because it's over. What flavors your goose down? What?
Well, at least he's going down. That's a plus.
There you go. That's it. No, but on this underwear topic that you're talking about now, you know, it's a little late to jump in on the news part, but like, sagging your jeans is now literally illegal. Like, 2 inches below your waistline, you're getting a ticket.
You yeah. should. No one needs to see that ass yeah. crack. It should be illegal.
Yo, you ain't, no, ain't nobody seeing my ass crack, though. I
a
got
little underwear? Okay.
I got my drawers, and I got my wife beater tucked in.
So are you saying you support
I
the say, ass-hanging
I
underwear revelation?
My pants. I sag my pants. I'm an old-school dude, you know? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, that's why Rebecca doesn't like me.
Yeah, saggy ass syndrome.
And then I got no butt. Like, I have no butt.
And he cannot lie. Look at this. Negativity in the ass area.
Right, and it's just, I got no, and no matter how tight I make the belt, I mean, you put rope around a stick, it's still going to slide down, you know what I mean? I think I got to do more squats.
Squats help. Or if you bend over and someone pushes something in your ass, that can help.
What's
too.
The biggest pickup line in the gay bar?
Oh, Jesus Christ, what?
Can I push your stool in? Oh, man. So, you know, I'm known for a couple of jokes. You know, people know me to make... Oh, I don't have any jokes. I've told jokes
false
in the
advertisement.
Past. Told jokes in the past. I'm known from everything from comedy to adult entertainment and hip-hop and everything in between. Not that I perform hip-hop.
Adult
that's
entertainment.
Just, yeah, my baby's arm.
Oh, Lord.
I sent my girlfriend a picture that she didn't like very much. But she asked me to send her a picture.
Okay.
And I put my junk next to the cable remote, you know?
It's as big as a remote?
Yeah, you know, the cable remote's got a little bit on me, like the top row of buttons, you know?
Oh, okay.
I don't have very many buttons on my penis.
Extra ridges and buttons.
Yeah.
Feeling
different. Yeah. Babe, was I coming close to that remote, though, or what?
Now he's trying to get validation
come
for
on.
The remote.
Come on. I mean, I'd put up the link, but I'm not allowed to do that. FCC
yeah, no.
and all that funness.
Pornographic, yeah. remote peep.
Anyways, you can check
that.
Me out on Pornhub. Shout out to White Bread Foster. He'll be our guest next week. But what I do have for you guys this week, as far as jokes and entertainment, I got a very funny. He's comical. He's musical. He's a well-rounded individual, rounded because he's got a little belly. And I really like his haircut. We'll go that way. Are you ready? I'd like to introduce to y'all, ladies and gentlemen, watching Leigh-Ality TV, my good friend, Mr. Keith Fitz. Oh. The third one. I went for the fourth one. That's the third one. Hang on. Easy.
Whoa. There we go. There now right. people can actually hear me. Thank you.
All right.
So, Lee, you said you tried it out against the cable remote, or was it a car remote?
You know the thing that unlocks the doors? What is that?
The thing that unlocks the doors?
Yeah.
Yeah, the car remote. Yeah. the mini pad. Yeah.
He's hung like a key fob.
So anyway.
A
key fob. Well, anyway, I know all two audience members out there are looking at me like, what the hell is Molto Mario doing here? This is not the stage of the Cooking Network. and some of you guys are just waiting for me to start singing. They're magically delicious.
How big are your lucky charms?
Smaller than the mini remote.
You speak so highly of yourself.
I sure do.
You're doing good.
That's because I am high. So I'm going to ask, well, the little audience that we have in here, are you guys happy it's 2014?
Yeah, I'm with it.
Yeah, I'm not. This year I turned 45 years old.
Ooh.
Every year around my birthday, my parents bust my balls. Key, when are you going to cut your hair? I keep telling them never, because when I get old enough, this becomes the ultimate comb over. Somebody told me I look like Foghorn Leghorn like this. Yeah. I thank you for the rim job. I'm starting to have things go wrong with my body now that I'm in my 40s, not like when I was in my 20s. Things like I have joints that are starting to predict the weather, which is kind of weird for weed, don't you think? I have diabetes now. My doctor says I absolutely have to stay away from candy, which is weird because they've been telling me the same thing at the strip club for years. Yeah. And I get Charlie horses at some of the most inopportune times, right? My wife comes out in a sexy negligee, and I'm getting a stiffy in my calf. I'm rubbing out my calf. She says, get over yourself, Key. You're Irish. You're not that big. Yeah. I'm starting to say things I never thought I would in my life. Things like I remember when. Things like I remember when sticking it to the man was not the slogan promoting gay marriage. Yeah. I remember when sexting was passing that note underneath the desk, do you like me, circle yes or no? I remember when a GPS was the woman sitting next to you in the car. Stop and ask for directions, will ya? Ask him. Ask him. Ask him. Recalculating. Yeah. I remember when standing in the bushes outside somebody's bedroom window was called hopelessly romantic. Some people remember the 80s. Good.
Yeah, now it's called stalking.
Yeah. Yeah.
I remember when Plan B contraception was, see ya! I remember when the original Amber Alert was, ladies and gentlemen, coming to the stage, Amber! And her one tooth. Yeah. I remember when the original iPad was Etch-a-Sketch. And Delete was... I felt bad for anyone with Parkinson's. On the same note, I remember when the original tablets is what they wrote the commandments on. Yeah.
I get it. It took me a second there.
Yeah. I remember when these jokes worked. I remember when it was cool for everybody to use the N-word. Hey, anybody want to come over and play with my Nintendo? I remember when Nigeria was so poor they couldn't afford to send that email. You know, the one that let me know the one that I won the lottery. Yeah. I like it, Lee. You let me know when a joke sucks. Thank you.
I'm actually updating.
He's like, that was the punchline?
I'm updating my status. I'm such a dick.
Thanks.
I'm such a dick.
Yeah, I remember when kids with ADD were simply cured by saying, shut up! I remember when going to the bathroom was not a Facebook status. I remember when every morning I would wake up and get morning wood. I'm so glad I got out of that prison. And I remember when I used to be able to move into a new neighborhood and not have to sign on to one of those online predator lists.
Oh.
I went to a Little League game. What did I know? I thought it was a nudist colony. So I mentioned my wife. My wife, she's a great woman. When she sleeps at night, she curls herself up in the covers, kind of like some sort of cocoon. So in the morning, I'm expecting this beautiful butterfly, right? No. No, instead, I get Mothra. I'm expecting, good morning, dear. Instead, I get, stop poking me with that thing. She wants to spice up our sex life in the bedroom. She's tired of the current routine. I climb on top of her while she's still snoring. So she wants to start bringing food into the bedroom. Now, me being a man of girth, I think this is the ultimate threesome.
Yeah.
Next time we got hot and heavy, I brought in a meatloaf. She looked me dead in the eye. She says, "Keep, get over yourself. What the hell do you think you're doing? Stop having sex with that meatloaf. You're making it more into a sloppy Joe." So Some of these jokes are just for me, Lee.
I love them.
Yeah. Anyway, so I suggested we do toys. It was good until I came home and found her in a threesome with my G.I. Joe and a Transformer. I do have a big announcement. My wife, she just had a baby.
Yay! Yay!
Thank you. That is until hospital security had caught up with her. No, we've been trying. We really have. I have a medical condition. It's called shooting blanks. The thing is, since we couldn't have the baby, we decided we were going to adopt. It was weird, though, because she decided that because we adopted, she could breastfeed, which I found weird because we adopted a goldfish. Yeah, she thought it was hungry because it went... So I sprinkled some flakes on her tits. I don't know about the goldfish. I ate well that night. Yeah. Yeah, this is Strong Island TV, by the way.
Yes.
Very nice. I originate from Strong Island. I originate from Brentwood. Anybody here familiar with that meth lab?
Oh yeah. Where's he from that?
White boy in Brentwood? Yeah. How many Brentwood, times did you get beat up?
I sold you drugs, didn't I?
No, that was another lonely white chick in Brentwood.
The only white chick in Brentwood or lonely?
Lonely.
Because I was going to say, if you're in Brentwood now, you are the only white chick in Brentwood.
Pretty much, same thing.
Yeah, my family was the last white family to move out. That's because the meth lab exploded. Yeah, I grew up an only child in Brentwood, which meant my parents had to play with me. Not like that, you pervertly. my parents used to suggest all kinds of activities. My mother suggested arts and crafts. She gave me scissors and said, "Run!" My father, we played sports. We played dodge car. And he drove. You guys are familiar with laser tag, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, my parents invented something new. It was called taser tag. You're it!
I think my neighbors play that.
10,000 volts in your ass, your hair would be red, too. And then for Christmas, all my friends got those things, the toys, the jack-in-the-box. I got fork in the toaster. So I had to come up with my own imaginary friend. My imaginary friend got me into all kinds of trouble, like the time we got caught playing doctor with grandma's respirator. Pull the plug, put it back in. Pull the plug, put it back in. Pull the plug. Put it back in. Plugged it into a clapper. Grandma, grandma, grandma. Her eyes open and shut like the lights. I still have my imaginary friend today. Now she's my sex partner. But we have to break up due to inconceivable differences. I caught her sleeping around on me. She told me it was all in my imagination. Imagine that. So I have a more realistic friend. She's breathtaking because she's inflatable. The only thing, all she does is this. I guess you guys never seen a windsock before.
Inflatable flailing tube man. How do you say it?
Yes, the flailing tube man, windsock, whatever the hell you want to call the damn thing. All right. Also, I am I'm a singer. I sing in a band. When I tell people this, they ask me the same question: when did the Partridge Family reunite? I look like Danny Partridge after he ate the other children. I was in a death metal band for diabetics. We were called Death by Chocolate. And now I want to see how sick your audience is.
All right.
I was out partying with my band one night. We were partying all night long. I got lucky. I went home with this girl. And I was getting me some. The whole time, though, she was insulting me. She was yelling out some other guy's name. Who names their kid rape?
Yeah.
Most people get who's your daddy. I got who are you. Yeah, and that's how I met my wife. I'm going to do a couple songs. You guys want to hear?
I want to hear a song. I love these
Irish songs.
They're awesome songs.
All right, because this studio seems to have like a really, really cool like one microphone system, I'm going to have to kind of do this a little bit.
I'm going to turn you up.
He's turning me up?
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. I get the feedback from behind me. All right. So the first song I like play for you guys is a little song I like to call the premature ejaculation song. Lee, you may want to back up a little bit. This gets kind of messy. Oh, thank you. Yeah, all right. I wrote a love song for my wife. Me and my wife, we've been married for about 10 years. And she had asked me to write her a love song. And I did. And I'd like to play it for you guys. The lighting in here, can I just have the lighting dimmed a little bit for the mood lighting? That's perfect. Thank you. The song goes something like this. ¶¶
I love this song.
I'm at home completely wasted, out of work and down. There's my wife, she won't stop nagging, she won't shut her mouth. I don't know what she's saying, it's all blah, 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 blah. If she don't shut her trap, I'll stick an old sock in her mouth. Cause she's breaking my balls, 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 breaking my balls.
A lot of married people in the studio, I see.
I'm at home, she won't stop crying, she won't shut her trap. Just cause I came from the strip club and somehow caught the clap. I don't know what she's saying, I thought I don't have a clue. If I did, I would be singling, banging prostitutes. Cause she's breaking my balls, breaking my balls, breaking my balls, breaking my balls. Alright, fuck it.
Keep it!
Alright.
I love it. You got one more. I know you got one more song for
me. Yeah, I'm going to leave you with this new one. It's a brand new one. It's not completely finished yet. I just want to try it out on
here. Wing it.
But I want to try it out. It's a little song I like to call the Crazy Cat Lady song, and it goes something like this.
The Jessica Collazo song?
Yeah, no, it's not specifically about her. It's just the Crazy Cat Lady song. And again, just give me a chance because it's not quite finished. It goes something like this. It's brand new. I don't remember all of the words.
Show me your pussy, cat lady.
That's it.
That's awesome.
What do you think? All right, thank you, everybody. I'm Keith Bates.
Excellent, Keith. Thank you, my brother. You're the man. Thanks, bro. That was great. Keith Fitz, ladies and gentlemen, find him on Facebook, Just The Way It Sounds, KEYFITZ. And I always love to ask his wife, Mrs., how does it fit?
Not very well.
All right. Yeah, hey, gee whiz on the one and twos. I'm so glad to have you here, my brother. I appreciate the hookup.
Thanks for having me.
Excellent. All right, so there's a pretty serious topic in the news today. I really don't like to get too serious. What? Oh yeah, you're on TV. I don't really like to get too serious, but there's some things we need to talk about, and you know, this tragedy with Tracy Morgan in the accident and everything. You know, we're wishing his family and friends, you know, the best of good wishes and get well soons and, you know, everything, all of that kind of stuff. And it turns out that the one gentleman that did pass away in the accident was his mentor, the guy that legit put him on. And as far as I'm told, that you know, dude, he didn't really get on himself, even though he put Tracy Morgan on. But, you know, in the end of the day, Tracy Morgan didn't forget the dude for helping him out. I was bringing him along the whole ride. You know what I mean? So when he wakes up, he's not going to be, you know, whatever, whatever. But, L.A., could we run that Tracy Morgan clip, please? For those of you who don't know who Tracy Morgan is or just a fan of his, here is a little sample. Baby, I hope you picked a good one. I picked the top one. That's an intro. Hey, I need an intro like that. Right?
What's good? What's happening? We're Brooklyn now. Yeah, Brooklyn in the house. Brooklyn always in the house. I did some shows in Australia. I said, "Where Brooklyn at?" They went, "Oh." I said, "How y'all got here?" I said, "We took the train." You get the train at home, skimmer horn. You don't go straight to Australia. Raised here. Grew up right down the block. Yo, man. Grew up right down the block in the 80s. Growing up in the 80s was crazy. I was a crack dealer. But I felt sorry for the crackheads. I would sell them crack and then feel sorry for them because I was a crack dealer with a heart of gold.
know that feeling.
I just couldn't take it no more. I got frustrated with doing that stuff. I had to stop because I got tired of, you know, them bringing me $3.20. I'm not counting all them pennies because you won't get high. What? Not today. Where the fuck you get 200 pennies from anyway? My arm was a crackhead, man. You get what I tell you? My arm was a crackhead. I remember one Christmas she bought me a Game Boy. I was like 12 years old. She bought me a Game Boy. And then she stole it. Then she helped me look for it. Yo, man, I was so heated. I was like, why you stole my Game Boy? And then help me look for it. She said, I had to eliminate myself as a suspect. Oh, man, things are getting dark out here, y'all.
Yeah, yeah.
Y'all better look at the world. The world is a ghetto. White people know how we feel. Now y'all want to occupy Wall Street. Black people occupy all streets. Know these things, man. It's scary when white people can't even save themselves now. I'm telling you, I'm a doomsday prepper. I went to Costco, so I got like 8,000 rolls of toilet paper. Getting dark, I see the incoming. White people, you have, white dude, you have an A spam? No, you better get used to it. Just save that spam key. That spam key is universal.
All right, so that's Tracy Morgan right there, ladies and gentlemen. He's very, very hilarious, obviously. And we're just wishing him the well wishes, you know what I'm saying? He needs our prayers and whatever your voodoo and everything else, whatever it is that Joe practice, that's, you know, send him some love, you know? Not just because he's famous and he's this and that, but because he's a human being.
Well, him being famous also brought out a lot of other visitors that might not have been so wanted.
Interesting.
Including his own mother.
Get out of here.
Apparently, they haven't talked in over 11 years, and she decided to now show up and make an appearance to check on her son. Yeah, fair weather mother, I guess, because they haven't spoken at all.
Well, at least she wasn't after him for bread his whole
career.
Well,
that's the last time they spoke.
Oh.
She was after him for money. She called him crying some sob story about how she needed money to pay for her house. And she made sure she put it all over the news, how he wouldn't even help out his own poor mother. And basically his response to that was he didn't think it was proper or the place to take care of family business, that it should be done privately and not in the media. So when Tracy Morgan's mom went to go visit him in the hospital, she was basically turned away and, of course, had to turn to the media again for that one.
So she's not really a caring mother. She's just like an attention-hungry
coattail
rider.
No, she's a spotlight chaser.
Yeah, gotcha. All right. Well, that's terrible. The whole situation is terrible. Let's get on to a better topic of happiness and joyfulness. And
speaking of happy,
one of my favorite things to do is listen to music and rock out and host events and party. And every time I ever throw an event, throw a party, have some kind of shindig, I need one particular ingredient, and that is my brother DJ G Wiz.
Hey.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you're back on TV. You're back on TV. There you are.
What's up, Mr. West?
What's up, brother? How you doing?
Shit.
Excellent. Are you ready for your questions?
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
While
that clip was running, I should have moved the table and stuff around, but now you guys can watch me do it.
I'm this is like my zone.
I know. I want to pull you out of your comfort zone.
Oh, no. Not today, Lee.
Not today. All right. Because he's got his little armpits hanging out. That's why. He didn't wear no sleeves.
Sleeves on.
All right. Gee whiz.
What's up, Mr. West?
Are you ready for the questions?
Yes.
Tell the people, I'm sure they already know, but tell the people who you are, where you're from, what do you do?
All right. My name is Gee Whiz.
Gee Whiz!
No, my DJ, that's not my government name.
No, it's fine. We don't
want to disclose that information today. All right, I'm from Broward, Long Island. And
B-Wood.
I DJ, you know?
A DJ.
Why the name Gee Whiz?
I don't know. My friend came up with that name for me one day. He goes, you need a DJ name. So I said, you know, my name is Greg. So he's like, Gee Whiz.
Gee Whiz.
So it's stuck for the past 15 years, you know?
Excellent. I love it. My favorite question, I got a lot of favorite questions. What was your first impression of the dude, Mr. Lee West, and where was the first meeting that we had?
Mr. Lee West. Was My first time meeting was online.
No. Yeah, I mean in the real life scenarios.
Wait a minute. Specify where online.
It was Craigslist.
Gay chat room.
It was a Craigslist.
Yeah, it was Craigslist, and it was men for men.
I figured.
And then I met him at the parking ride on over there by the hot dogs.
53 on the LIE. Robes optional.
Parking pickle. No, I believe it was. Was it my birthday?
It was your birthday.
It was the Rose Theater.
Your birthday. At the Rose Theater.
At the Rose
yes.
Theater, and it was the 10th anniversary of my 21st birthday.
You're shot.
That's what it was.
That was cool, man. We had a good time.
Yeah, we had a great time. I mean, like, you know, the dude, he's mad funny on Facebook and everything, and I could tell he's professional. He answers my call when I call him. You know, it's a big thing. And he hit it with that smoke and those lights, and the whole room erupted, you know?
It was great, man.
It was really... It
you
was
did
really
comedy that day, too.
You know, it's my party. I could do whatever I want.
Of course.
I rented this room. The only thing I couldn't have was strippers because, the landlord says... Is the landlord here right now? I don't think so. Let me just fucking take some tits out.
They have a no stripper clause in your lease?
The place I was renting was weird. No nudity. It's like, how do they know? What happens when I gotta go to the bathroom? Like, I can't even take my weenus out?
Nope.
Like,
no nudity allowed. I actually was going to rent an apartment from someone, and this lady actually had the nerve to say, there's no fornication allowed, no premarital sex. I said, what? I'm out of here.
So, Wizzy, you being of Puerto Rican descent, what do you prefer to spin? You prefer hip-hop, or do you prefer Latin music?
I prefer everything, man. Whatever gets the people going.
Word. You know? I feel that. Yeah, that's one of my favorite things about you, bro. All you do is he looks out.
You got to read the crowd.
And he just... And whatever he's doing, and the little press on the buttons in this, he knows exactly what the crowd needs, exactly at the right time, and exactly what they want. And
can he play something now?
He can play something now after the questions.
Show everybody what you got.
There's more questions.
Of course, spin. Just throw us a little drop. Let me get a little Gee Whiz flavor. Yeah, there's some mix of new and do it.
Hold on, Lee. Ready? Like the video, like.
Oh, like in the boat, right? And everybody falls out of the boat. That's a good one.
There you go.
For instance.
All right.
Keep going.
That
was
good. No, but I mean, that's just like a quick little sample of it.
Yeah,
I mean, I came and seen Wizzy spinning a couple times at this Smithtown spot, whatever. They don't pay us to say the name.
Oh, man, that freaking place was like packed.
Yeah, it was packed out. And I did pretty all right in there, too. Yeah, and so he goes...
It was funny. My, who was it?
Yeah. Mouse.
I thought Lee was a Puerto Rican until I saw him... dancing.
White boy can't dance.
Like, I thought he was Puerto Rican.
I get mistaken for Puerto Rican lots of times.
That's not bad.
I'm not sure if it's the beard line or my pocket knife.
Oh, shit.
It's got to be the beard.
Where is it? There it is. Yeah, most Puerto Ricans can't afford my knife. No.
There you go.
It's
you
all
lost
love.
The
it's all love.
Spanish nice. Viewer we have.
It's all love. All right, so we got that. What was the first? So you've been DJing how long, Wizzy?
About 16 years.
About 16 years. So you carried around crates of vinyl.
Absolutely. That was
awesome.
A pain in the ass.
That's awesome.
I'm so glad that's gone. Whatever DJ says, you carry vinyl, screw those guys, man. Those guys suck.
Excellent.
They all have hernias now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Those guys got bad backs, wearing the brace, everything else.
It was a lot of work.
But as far as mixing and scratching and everything, you prefer the new style or?
I like the new style.
Yeah.
This is a lot easier than 100 crates of records.
You know? And you got to look through them.
Oh, yeah.
Each one.
You got to RPM.
And get it ready before you put it on.
You know? And then, like, somebody like me, you know, I'm like one of those club rats who hang out in the DJ booth just to feel cool. And I like the view. You can see everything. I'm a short guy. You know, so for me to, like, be up there, it's cool, you know?
Like, every time Lee comes to the club, I'm like, let that guy up here right
now. Yeah, put him right here.
Let him up here right now.
Yeah, it's good.
Well,
it's
at least you scratch. There's a lot of DJs that just put on a CD or play the song from the computer. It's like,
music.
How do you call yourself a DJ? Anybody could press play.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. Exactly.
doing it for too long.
What's your favorite song of all time, Wizzy?
Favorite song of all time? That's a hard question, man. They're all good, you know?
Yeah, I don't have a favorite. I don't have a favorite song either.
I don't know. Stairway to Heaven?
Very nice.
Yeah, Stairway to Heaven.
I like never would have guessed that.
I like that. I like how you switch it up. You'd be surprised. No, yeah, exactly. Once you're exposed to every music, you know, you can really get a feel for what you're really feeling. And as a whole, you know, because we're on the island, we're doing a lot of Long Island events, and I represent Strong Island, you represent Strong Island. Sir. And how do you feel about the local venues?
They're all right. You know what? They were a lot better back in the day, you know?
Right.
Now they're, the music sucks in a lot of places, you know, because of the promoter. I'm going to be honest. You know, the promoter kind
of
ruined
the
club scene. You know, he tells the DJs what to play. And
it's all about the bread and not about the love. Yeah, you gotta have the love for the art. You gotta have the love for the music. You have to have the, you know, it can't always be all about the money, you know? Like,
without a doubt.
I had a guy in the shop today. Shout out to the day job, Training Man Transmission, 1052 West Jericho Turnpike, Smithtown. I had a guy in the shop today.
You do trannies?
I do trannies.
Hey.
well, I got to say it like that. I had a guy in the shop today. He says, are you rich and famous yet? And I was like, well, I'm working on the famous, and I've been rich my whole life.
There you go.
I got family and friends that love me, and I couldn't be any richer than that.
Everywhere but your pocket.
Exactly.
Is there, speaking of events, do you have any events coming up? Anything good going on?
I kind of stay out of the club scene. I do a lot of weddings and, you know.
Private parties,
birthdays.
That's
you know.
Good.
Remember that Sweet 16, son?
Oh, it was a good time.
That was a great time. I got a little drunk for hosting a Sweet 16. But
a little drunk? You did nice.
Yeah.
Nah, it was good. You did good.
I held the composure, you know, but it was good, though. We had a good time.
I had to take the mic away at one point. I was like, Lee.
I'm done. It's all. Yo, man. Not even going to say it. But at least I put a shirt on. Mouse didn't even put a shirt on.
Mouse was shot.
Shout out to Mouse. What up, Mouse? I could have gave him a shirt, too. He's the same size as me, except he's in shape, and I'm not.
How old is Mouse? We're running around with no shirt on.
No. He had a shirt. It just wasn't.
Oh, well, you have to explain that. You made it sound like he's streaking around a Sweet 16.
You say, like, listen, tell Mouse to put a shirt on this time, right? It's hilarious.
Yeah, hot head. He's like, I thought it was one of your parties, bro. Yeah.
Streaking allowed at Lee's parties?
Absolutely. Right. You've never been to the hot tub.
No.
You're scared.
I'll skip.
And then the support from your family. Like, everybody's on board with your DJing.
Thank God, man, because a lot of people don't have that support. You know?
Exactly. So exactly.
It's always good that family's by your corner, all your friends, you know, support what you do.
Yeah.
They've always been there, you know?
I like that a lot.
It's really cool. Yeah, shout out to my family. Guys.
Yeah. Oh, G-Wiz fam. I love it. That's good stuff, man. And shout out to Mrs. Wizzy.
Mama Wiz and Papa
Mama Wiz. Yeah. That's right.
Remember that on Mother's Day? I was like, yo, Mrs. Wiz.
Oh, yeah.
Word. She probably hates that.
I'm probably the only person calling. All right.
Yeah,
we got
man,
all
listen,
this stuff.
Thanks for having me today, man.
Yo, man, I really appreciate you coming through.
Down and,
hit me with a couple of joints. Let me, mix the drop in, do a little something. Give me 5 minutes.
You got it.
5 minutes of DJ G-Wiz coming right at you on Leigh-Ality TV, StrongIsland.com.
Yeah, yeah. Special girl, real good girl. Biggest thing in my itty bitty world. Caught her up and she made me feel right. Wish the bliss could never take flight. Sitting back with this mic in my hand. Spitting hot shit, trying to see grand. Imprinted on my mind every minute. Make my plans and you always in it, y'all. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant. And even though we both fly, give each other space and not the evil eye. Acting like grown-ups, don't even try to hide cause the spot blown. Girlfriend telling you she wanna see. I say I don't know, but you say gladly. And when we both do head, we go on and on and on and on and
real love.
Don't leave.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let me get you dropped, G. Yeah, you do it again. Gee whiz. I love it. I love it. I appreciate all your help last night, too, my brother.
No doubt, man. Anytime.
You putting that sample together, that my that little cool intro.
It was a good time.
Yeah, we have fun. We always have a good time.
Yeah, I was getting twisted. I had a few Heinekens.
Did you? I saw you were like two or three when I saw you, and then you would you finish them?
Oh, forget it. I think I had about too many.
Too many. I like it. Yeah. And he slept on the couch. I saw his pillows and everything all set up so that way ain't nobody got to worry about that.
Did you have a Snuggie?
Yeah, I had a Snuggie.
All right. So one of my favorite pastimes, Wiz, Becca.
What's that?
Strung out.
Smoking?
Smoking. Titties. Who doesn't love titties in their face, right?
Well, if you're not a lesbian, then.
Oh, Becca.
Well, I'm not.
So you can't just admire a bitch's beauty because you're not a lesbian, you know?
I've been. I'm not a hater.
No. Well, I do enjoy going, you know, burning a couple bucks in the titty bar.
Right. But do you like getting totally taken advantage of? Your credit card getting totally freaking racked?
This is what they do.
Thousands of dollars, kind of.
This is what they do. Jeez. You know, they hustle. They hustle. And these broads, I feel, have mastered the art of the hustle.
Well, the ones that have really mastered the art of the hustle are the strippers of New York City Scores.
Yeah.
There's been a scandal going on since last November, December, where four strippers have organized a credit card racking ring where basically they go out, they do some footwork, they go to local bars, they check out guys, and they basically see what they have to offer. When they meet the criteria, which is having a lot of money, they basically invite them to the strip club and then bring them into a private room and drop something in their drink. They get them so fucked up that they have no idea what's going on, and they just swipe, 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 swipe.
I think it's being a little blown out of proportion.
No. Four guys, four different people. There's like a doctor, a real estate guy, four different men, just four. Uh-huh. Over 130,000 to 190,000 just on them alone.
You know what happened with those particular four guys? They got caught by their wife. Now they come up with this whole cockamamie scheme. I didn't blow all them racks on these strippers. I went there. We were trying to do a little Molly turn up, and he just couldn't hang.
Nope.
He just can't hang. These broads drink and whack out all day long, and then these dudes try to jump right in the mix. You know, and try to get right in there. Wiz, you feel me on this?
Maybe one dude got caught by the wife. He woke up in his house. The other guys, one guy woke up in a car, woke up in a hotel, had no idea what happened. They started piecing it together because one stripper got pulled over for a DUI, and she had a bag full of Molly, like a whole ship of it. So she couldn't really play innocent. But
it's kind of like, what?
Yeah, well, you fake titties in a bag of Molly, honey, you're not innocent.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So what are they being brought up on charges, or what's the situation?
Currently pending investigation. There's also a bouncer that's involved with the scandal.
Of course, you need somebody on the inside.
Right. They believe that he's kind of a ringleader and that he organized the girls, but that's, you know, strippers. Awesome. They don't need a dude to help them get money. They'll go get their own.
I knew this one guy who had this one little racketeering thing going on in the strip club, and he'd go up to a guy and he'd say, listen, you see that girl over there? Da-da-da-da. You take her for a lap dance. Before the lap dance starts, you give her a $100 bill.
And what does he get?
That means you just bust out with the 100 beforehand. That's how. That's the clue. That's the key. She's going to fuck you in there.
Oh.
Right? But meanwhile, they go in there. This guy's like, oh, I'm going to nail this broad. Bust out a Benny. Bong. Gives it to her. He gets a regular lap dance. He's pissed off as hell. Right?
Did he get a refund?
No. The stripper comes out and hands this individual who set the whole thing up $50.
Wow.
So the dude would just sit in there. Yo, bro, go over there. Bum, bum.
Boom.
$50.
That's nice.
Ain't it?
Nice.
That's easy money. Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Shame on that guy who gave up $100.
All pay, no play.
Right, you know what I mean? If you're going to be stupid, you're going to be stupid. You know what I mean? Like, you're paying for nanny, there's problems. You know? So who cares? He got you for $50. He got you for $100. Whatever.
Well, at least he didn't get anything else from the strippers.
Sit for herpalitis?
Yeah, you know.
All right, we got 5 minutes left. We're gonna go to one of my favorite things. We called scores, and we wanted to find out a little bit about how to get in there and do
a hiring process.
Yeah, how to be a dancer, and let's find out how that call went. Becca has the calls. She's gonna pull that up, and I think it should be pretty good. Becca does the great voices. Oh yeah.
This one I did my real voice. I didn't disguise it.
There you go. Plug it in, Becca. Stuff it in. No.
Calling for a job.
Thank you, brother.
Scores New York. Hello. I am calling for a job.
Okay, for what kind of job?
I'm currently dancer, and I'm looking for a new position in different location.
Sure, you can come in tonight or any night between 9 p.m. and midnight.
9 p.m. midnight. Is it usually require audition?
Yes.
Okay, what type of thing should I bring? What type
You need a long gown.
Long gown.
A G-string. And stiletto heels.
Stiletto.
And an ID.
ID. Okay. The other thing I have a question about. Currently, I work in another location, and basically, they even in home in Russia, they tell us basically it's important to talk to guy, try to take money, get as much money as you can. Is
she
this a type of thing that would be good for business?
Well, I mean, you just give the lap dances and, you know, do what you would normally do. We don't encourage you to try to take anybody's money.
Take the money.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not a good idea to try to get them to maybe...
I can't discuss that. You know what? You'd have to speak to the manager about that. Okay?
Oh. Okay,
and he'll be here after 7 o'clock.
Okay, well, I have many, many talents and skill and...
okay, could you call back after 7, please?
Right,
thank you.
Right.
She knew I was fucking
with
her.
Yeah, she was
going to
fuck
her. She's like, oh, wait a minute. We're all over the news. I don't think
Yeah. I don't need no exploiting at the moment. All right, what else happened today, Becca?
Well, you pick. We have a massage parlor, gay mannequins.
Let's do the rub and tugs.
Oh, all right. Let's see. There's one I did by accident, and I didn't realize I disguised my voice. It sounds like a chipmunk, which is hysterical because they stay on the phone. Or the one I do in like my real voice is like a Chinese. Which one do you want?
Whatever you think is funnier.
Well, my friend said the chipmunk one was hysterical, but You want to try that?
Chipmunk it is. Right. Alvin, Alvin going for rubbing tugs. Are you serious? I gotta start reviewing these.
Why are you?
I don't realize it sounds like that until after the call. I'll do the real one.
All right, helium sucking Alvin. Yeah, we're gonna skip to another one because that's just a little too heliumized Alvin. And last one. We're gonna do one more and then we're gonna get out of here.
All right. This is the real voice one.
Hello, Matthew. Oh, hello. I need to make an appointment for massage. Okay. What time do you want coming? I like to come all the time, but I want to make sure you have a special package available. Do you do Meow Meow Downtown? Yes. Oh, okay. I like a lot of Meow Meow Downtown and Shoki Poki. You do Bordeaux?
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Oh, Stocky Pokey, a special...
Astoria, Astoria. Downtown is Astoria. Queens is Astoria. Okay.
Oh, you do Astoria massage?
Astoria.
How much you charge for all three little massage? Is it our rate?
Yeah, hold on 1 second.
Hello?
Okay,
Queens. Oh, hello. I want to come and get massage and try to get price and appointment time.
You do the acupuncture, it's the massage.
Oh, acupuncture. I thought she's the Astoli.
Where is the Broadway Astoria? The Ajesi. You do the massage, right?
Oh, yes. Tokyo downtown, Astoli.
All right, that's hilarious.
I need to come. Me and my boss, he like to get Asahori Toki Poki. How much you charge?
Oh, charge is the hour $50.
$50
for 6 minutes.
$50 make you hungry.
Oh, for 60 minutes. Okay. Yeah. You do happy ending?
No.
Oh, come on, we ain't going in.
I call Special Asia Massage Parlor. I want to get happy ending. What kind of massage parlor are you?
Sorry, you want to understand? We're just the back massage, back and neck and the feet.
Oh my God, that's crazy, back.
You told me you do after holy massage, stocky pokey, down, meow meow downtown.
I don't understand what you say. Sorry.
All right.
I don't understand.
No, wait.
Hold on.
She's crazy. All right, that's Badass Becca's prank calls. We love that segment of the show. Real quick, I just want to shout out the sponsor, Cage Refrigeration, for all your heating and cooling needs. Call my brother Bobby at 631-813-8633. Cage Refrigeration, Cage with a K. I'm Lee West. That's Badass Becca. Thank you to the Key Fits, DJ G Wiz.
Hey. Thanks for having me, guys. Appreciate it.
Next week, Thursday, StrongIsland.com, 8 p.m. Leigh-Ality TV.